Die Heimspiele der Munich Cowboys werden Ihnen präsentiert von
Werksviertel Mitte. Urbanität neu erleben.
Ja, meine sehr verehrten Damen und Herren, ich darf Sie herzlich begrüßen zur Pressekonferenz nach unserem ersten Heimspiel und gleichzeitig den ersten bayerischen Derby in diesem Jahr, der Munich Cowboys gegen die Kirchdorf Wildcats. Darf ich Ihnen kurz das Podium hier vorne vorstellen. Zu meiner Rechten ganz außen Alex Braunsberger, Running Back der Kirchdorf Wildcats. Dann Christoph Riener, Head Coach der Kirchdorf Wildcats. Dann zu meiner Linken Jalen Zachary, unser weiteres Receiver, der heute einige Touchdowns gemacht hat, und Head Coach Garen Holly. Fangen wir mit den Gästen an. 27-27, einer kürzer wie letztes Jahr hier in München. Wie hast du das Spiel gesehen?
Ja, natürlich unzufriedenstellend, für beide Seiten vermutlich. Wir haben gewusst, dass wir kein Vorbereitungsspiel gemacht haben und deswegen einen holprigen Start erwischen werden. Das war tatsächlich so. In der zweiten Halbzeit haben wir ein bisschen besser ins Spiel gefunden. Nichtsdestotrotz waren wir jetzt nicht besonders zufrieden mit der Leistung. Vielleicht war es deswegen ein verdientes Unentschieden. Aber Sieg wäre schöner gewesen, aber tatsächlich haben wir heute zu viele Fehler gemacht, um mit einem Sieg davon zu gehen.
Ihr hattet, oder beide Mannschaften hatten eigentlich noch die Möglichkeit zu punkten, somit ist es vielleicht tatsächlich ein gerechtes Unentschieden. Hattet ihr mit dem Kampfspiel gerechnet, so wie es jetzt eigentlich gekommen ist?
Na gut, das Wetter ist natürlich ein Faktor, deswegen war das eventuell schon absehbar. Mein Kampf ist es immer und erste Liga ist erste Liga, das darf man sich wenig Fehler erlauben. Es haben sie beide Seiten Fehler erlaubt und dementsprechend ist das Spiel so gelaufen. Dass das ein einfacher Durchmarsch ist, glaube ich, hat das niemand erwartet jetzt in dem Umfeld.
Dankeschön. Garen, one point better than last year, but still, is there a curse with the first game, home game?
I don't know if there's a curse. There's definitely a weather curse because it's always like this for game one. But at the end of the day, going into a game when you can't scout a team, it's always 50-50. So we had to go off personnel, and we knew we could take advantage of some matchups. They were prepared for some of the stuff that we did defensively to them last year, so that was very good by them. They found a way to get the ball to their import early in the second quarter, and they did a really good job with their kickoff return team. So they definitely had the upper hand on special teams, and I think that was a big factor today, is they won the special teams battle for sure. That allowed them to stay in the game, and we almost let it slip away and ended up with a tie. So we're not happy about the tie, but the growth we've seen with our team the last 2 years and games that happen like this, we generally fold and the game gets ugly. So that's one thing that we're taking away from this, is we were able to stay together and fight, and we gave ourselves a chance at the end of the game.
Thank you. Alex, ihr habt das Laufspiel gleich am Anfang relativ gut etablieren können. Gib uns mal ein paar Eindrücke, wie du das Spiel gesehen hast.
Ja, aber was wir ins Spiel gekommen sind, war es auch auf dem Gameplan, dass wir erstmal einen Lauf etablieren können, da wir 5-Man-Box haben und einfach da versucht haben, den Ball durch zum Laufen. Ansonsten ja, war es so hin und her die ganze Zeit. Also Cowboys waren dann in der Halbzeit vorne und dann haben wir mit ein paar Punkten ausgeglichen. Dann hat das hin und her, ja, ist das hin und her weitergegangen. Und zum Schluss ist es leider so blöd. Also unentschieden ist, fühlt sich komisch an. Man mag natürlich gewinnen. Also Overtime war schon cool gewesen, aber ja, das ist so.
Denken wir mal drüber nach. Jalen, many very good catches today. Some touchdowns from you. It was wet, but you still got the ball, right?
Yeah, definitely. The weather was definitely a factor today, but you know, we didn't let it make an excuse. I just took advantage of every ball I got and, you know, just made the plays I know I can make.
Thank you. Gibt es Fragen von Seiten der Medien?
Coach, You mentioned the weather. How much of the penalties was weather related, you would say, and how much is... I'm sorry, I got to ask about penalties, probably just like last year.
Yeah.
How much of that was weather related, you think, and how much is
I don't really
not in sync yet?
I don't really know. I wasn't really paying attention. Like you just kind of see the flag. You're like, what in the God's name can that be? And then sometimes, you know, you refer to your other coaches that like, hey, they're like, yeah, that's legitimate, you know. Or if it's one that it's just like, what is going on? But weather-wise, you can't control it. And I don't know how much of that affected penalties. We did enough to damage ourselves with some penalties for sure. So it's not one of those we can – pass the blame onto the officials. There were definitely some questionable ones, as always, but that's football. So weather and penalties, I wasn't really focused on whether that was a factor.
Short comment, please, on Brady's opening game.
Yeah, for an opening game, it's the strongest start we've had by a quarterback in the last 3 years. So hats off to him. We knew his athletic ability could be utilized. He ran himself out of air. He was running so much because they have a great D-line as well. So, I mean, for a first week playing that type of D-line, you're going to have to be prepared. We had a 19-year-old starting at guard. So you got a 19-year-old that just moved up playing against one of the best D-linemen in Europe. He was able to hold his own and do a good job. But at the same time, Brady did a good job of diagnosing the coverages, and we were able to attack them vertically and find open people. He did a good job of extending plays, and in the run plays, he did a good job of being effective. We knew we had that with him. He just has that competitive attitude, like when it was 3rd and 20-something, he just takes off. And he's athletic enough to just run it straight up the field and not go down and push the pile by himself. So that just tells you the type of player he is and what he brings to the table for us. But we have to find a way when we play good D-lines to not put it all in his hands. And, again, find ways to get our running backs going. We did the best we could considering their strong front. So, and we're missing two guys up front as well. So it was just one of those games that we did the best we can do, and it was acceptable, and we'll find ways to be better because we got a tough matchup next week.
Thank you.
Gibt's weitere Fragen? Das ist nicht der Fall. Dann darf ich auf unser nächstes Spiel hinweisen. Am kommenden Samstag, den 11. Mai um 17 Uhr in Schwäbisch Hall gegen den Deutschen Meister. Dann unser nächstes Heimspiel wird sein am Samstag, den 1. Juni um 16 Uhr wieder hier im Münchner Dante-Stadion gegen die Allgäu Comets. Ich darf mich bedanken bei unseren Sponsoren, dem Bergsviertel Mittler, den Papenberger Security und der Goldenen Rakete für die tollen Burger heute. Und darf meinen Dank auch an alle weiteren Sponsoren und Partner richten. Ja, das Wetter war zum Auftakt nicht ganz so schön. Hoffen wir auf Besserung in diesem Bereich. Herzlichen Dank, dass Sie da waren, und auf bald wieder. Munich Cowboys for a ride. Munich Cowboys worldwide. Munich Cowboys for the dream. Munich Cowboys our team. Munich Cowboys for a ride. Munich Cowboys worldwide. Munich Cowboys for the dream. Munich Cowboys our team.